Good, how are you today?
Good. Is your weather cold up in Asheville today?
Yes, it's actually been snowing here today, but and it's like 18 degrees.
Oh, wow. Because I'm in South Mississippi, so it's like cold for us, but it's like in the low 40s, but we're still like all act like we're bundled and act like it's snowing. So.
Yeah, this is like so cold you don't want to like go outside for more than like 2 minutes.
Right? You just want to bundle up, stay inside, stay low.
Yeah, basically.
Coffee. Yeah. Well, good. I'm glad you've joined us today. Your niche is wedding photography and engagements and all that lovey-dovey stuff, right?
Yes, it is.
How long have you been shooting?
I started shooting in 2010, right after I got married, and just kind of took off from there. And then about a year into shooting, I realized that I really wanted to specialize in weddings and engagements.
Awesome. Was you getting married, like, did that spark that interest and just understanding the behind the scenes of a wedding and the meaning and stuff? Did that kind of spark that niche for you think?
I would say it did. It definitely played a part. I started photography when I was a little girl, just as a hobby that I enjoyed. And then when I was in high school, I started taking photography courses at a local community college. And then from there, I kind of just realized, hey, I'm really passionate about this. Like, I think it's something I could turn into a career and really enjoy doing. And then when I got married, it was just at that point that I really had like the I guess the means to start doing it. So that's when I started.
That's awesome. That's awesome. I know I've only been married a little over a year, and so I shot weddings my first like 4 or 5 years of my business, and then I just realized it's really not my full-blown passion, so I kind of backed away a little bit. But after getting married and just, like I said, the behind the scenes and the meaning behind everything, it's just kind of almost sparked me to be like, ooh, I'd like to shoot weddings again.
Yeah, totally.
So, 'cause it's like I now can place myself in that bride's, position and the day and the excitement and the stress, So I didn't know if that kind of sparked you, but that's really cool. So, what do you shoot with? What's your gear?
I shoot with a 5D Mark III, and I started shooting Canon from the get-go just because I guess it's what I shot when I was a teenager. And when I started my business, I had a Canon Rebel, and then I just kind of progressed from there and upgraded whenever I had the opportunity.
That's awesome. I'm a Canon shooter too, so yay.
Canon.
I know. I'm like you. My granddad was a photographer, and then my dad was just an amateur photographer. And so they both shot with Canon. So when I started to purchase my equipment, I mean, all I knew was Canon. Like, that was the only option. So that's why that kind of fell in my lap. So, but today I just want us to talk about some posing tips for these up-and-coming photographers or even photographers that are already currently shooting weddings or engagements. I just want to get some more tips and input on posing and how you have beautiful work, by the way, and just how you bring out their personalities, you bring out that love that they have for each other. So let's just jump into it. Tell us a little bit about your style when it comes to posing and your niche.
My style of posing is definitely very intimate and I guess you could say touchy-feely. I'm not the photographer for a couple if they are not comfortable with, like, hugging or kissing or nuzzling. That's just I tell them right off from the bat, if you're not comfortable with this, I'm probably not the right fit for you. Just because I guess I'm kind of a romantic at heart, and so for me, I just love to like pose people very closely and like very just touching, and I like that connection that it gives whenever people are touching in portraits.
So let's jump into your tips with getting them to even feel comfortable or just how you're going to pose them. So what would be your number one tip for us today of just getting them to, get intimate and get lovey and touchy?
My number one tip would absolutely be to get them talking. When I start a session, the first thing I try to do is I go up, I introduce myself, I start talking to them about how they met or what their wedding plans are, if they've set a date yet. And I found through the years of doing this that if I can get people talking, they automatically start to loosen up and become more comfortable with me. And the more comfortable they are with me, the easier it is to pose them throughout the session.
And that's so true. We're all so much more comfortable when there's conversation that we can engage in and, you know, feel a part of who each other are in that setting. So I know even when I teach people with shooting and posing and stuff, I'm always like, you got to talk to them. Just talk, whether it's just, you know, everyday little talk or questions, just talk, because it makes them feel so comfortable. One of the other tips you mentioned was just starting your whole session with like some easier poses. So what would be your thoughts with that?
I think that sometimes as photographers, we forget that to us, this is nothing new, but to the people we're shooting, unless they're a celebrity, like this is very new to them. So when I do a session, I try to start with simpler poses and then go into the more difficult poses as things progress and as they become more comfortable. So for example, I'll do like some easy things like the guy leaning in to kiss the girl on the cheek, or the couple leaning in and touching noses and just looking at each other. And then as they start to warm up, we start doing the harder things. And I think it really helps that I do that, because I would like hate to start out the session with these really hard poses and then leave my couple feeling like, oh, I didn't know what to do, like I felt so awkward. Like, I want them to be comfortable. Like, that's one of my top concerns. So that's what I try to do when I pose them.
Yeah, I mean, even like when we're on the other side of the camera, from time to time, we're that, you know, client. But even when we're comfortable posing, like, we even look at our images and we're like, oh, that's us. We love those. So, like you said, if we just put our, you know, our feet in their shoes type idea, if they're comfortable, they're going to love the images that you give them.
Right. And that's our goal, and that should always be our top concern.
Yes. So what would be, because you mentioned a couple of your easier poses, what would be like a couple of your harder poses, or do you want to save that for later?
Some of my harder poses would definitely be like couple. I love to do people like laying on the ground, and I like to shoot them from above, and that can be hard to do just because how you would normally lay on the ground isn't how you have to do it for it to photograph well. So that's definitely something that I would do later on. Stuff like picking up, like having the guy pick up the girl to kiss her and like leaning back, that's a harder pose for sure. So I usually don't do that until like the very end of the session.
Sure. And they're going to love those because they're already comfortable throughout the whole session. So what about when it comes to, like, you know, you mentioned the harder poses. Do you ever, because I know you kind of mentioned this to me earlier, but how do you get them to actually portray what you have in your mind and what you're wanting that final outcome to be?
I'll tell them what to do, so I'm very specific with directions on hand placement, foot placement, even like looking at me or not looking at the camera. But if I feel like a couple is really struggling, I will go and model it myself with my own body, just because I feel like sometimes like seeing another human do it like makes it, I don't know, just all of a sudden click in their mind. So that's something that I'll do just to help them, you know, be more comfortable. And a lot of times, like, if I'm testing out a new pose or something and I feel like it's awkward for me to model, I probably won't go back to that pose, just because I'm like, well, it's awkward for me and I'm a photographer, so it's got to be, like, awkward for them too. So I just won't do that pose.
Right. And like you said, giving him clear the direction. And sometimes people are just visual, so they need to see it. And then, like you said, it kind of gives you a test, too. If this is awkward, let's tweak it a little bit. I know I've had that before. I've been like, if it's not comfortable, let's just not do it, you know. Because sometimes we as photographers have little posing fails, you know. We're not perfect either. Have you ever had, like you got the pose, a pose you always do, but the couple's just not a fit for it? Have you ever had that happen?
I've definitely had that happen. It really just depends, like, on the couple and how comfortable they are. And, you know, not everybody expresses their love by touching, like, in the same way. So some people, it's not as natural for them to do some of my, you know, favorite poses. And if that's the case, I just don't do that pose. I try to find what works best for them individually as a couple.
Sure. And I think that's key in being, you know, a great engagement photographer, is, like you said, knowing them ahead of time, or just being able to pick up on their personality and what they're comfortable with and expressing their love, and using those poses that'll only just encourage that and let it just shine, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
What about, I know one of the things you've mentioned in your little interview that we're talking about, and it's something that's very common, it seems like even our clients always say, what do I do with my hands? So you said just watch the hands and being, you know, attentive to that. What are some things you look for?
Well, I think it took me a while to learn this as I was shooting and learning my style and stuff, but a lot of times I would feel like I had this great picture and I would be going back through my pictures and then I would look at the hands and I would be like, oh my gosh, I can't keep this picture. Their hands look so awkward. They don't look natural. They look tense. They look like they're uncomfortable in the pose. And so one of the things I try to do is just watch my couple's hands placements during the session. And if I feel like they're not looking natural, I'll tell them to do like one of two things. I'll either tell them to like release their hands and like shake them out, which I know sounds kind of weird, but it gets them just to like loosen their fingers. And then I'll also tell them, like, I'll help place their hands and I'll place my hand over it and I'll say, okay, like soften your hand. And just the act of telling them that sometimes helps them to like loosen up and not be as tense. And it like totally changes the picture. I know it seems like such a small thing, but we express ourselves with our hands, and so I feel like it's something that you really do have to be mindful of.
Yes, absolutely. And, you know, anytime they are comfortable and their hands are comfortable and they feel secure, again, it's only going to help your images just be ones that they fall in love with.
Right. And that's what we want. Like, I don't want my clients to go back and go, oh my gosh, like this looks so great, but you can tell I'm uncomfortable from my hands or from my eyes or from anything like that. So I just try to make sure that people are looking natural and looking like themselves.
Sure. All right, so on your little lovey-dovey images, and you've got them nuzzled and all this little stuff, what are some things you might tell them to encourage them to bring out that romantic, emotional side?
There's a few little things that I do. I'll definitely like tell them to lean in and touch noses or to look into each other's eyes and think about the first time that they met. Or even when I'm doing pictures of them where they're facing me front on, I'll tell them to like touch, you know, their faces together just because I found that it makes them look so much more connected. And then another thing that I really like to do is I like to tell the guy to whisper something funny in his fiance's ear. And I found that that can produce some really great like natural laughing or kissing photos. So that's something that I like to get them to do.
That's awesome, because every photographer has their own little way of, you know, bringing out that emotion. And I feel like when it's your passion, it's your love, you just have your little, you know, things you always know to tell that couple, and it just like pulls it out of them somehow. It's like magic.
Yeah, and I feel like the more you get to know your couples beforehand, the easier it is to do that. So like, you know, you can reference back to their story and talk to them about that. And I think just reminding them sometimes of the simple act of how they came together can make them be that much more, you know, lovey and intimate in their photos.
Absolutely. Which we're not really talking about today as far as, you know, the pre-planning of an engagement session, or more of the posing. But do you ever do any like pre-planning with the couple or by yourself as far as your posing or the session goes?
I definitely do a lot of pre-planning just because personally that's my style. I like to be very organized. I like to get to know my couples. One of the things that I do is a thing called a getting to know you form, and it's just got some basic questions on there about them, how they met, their wedding style, if they want to incorporate props into their session, what they envision for their session, and just doing that really helps me to get a grasp on what they are wanting to see the finished product from these engagement photos. I would hate for them to get them back and be like, oh no, this is not what I envisioned at all. So I found that just doing that prep work beforehand really does help the actual session to be a success.
Absolutely, because then all it does, you know, really it makes one big circle. Once again, it just connects you even tighter with your client to get to know them better, to make them more comfortable so that they'll love their images even more. And anytime a client's involved in their session, like you said, with that get to know you thing, like they're involved in it emotionally and time. And so I think that's a huge asset probably to your business as well.
Yeah, it definitely is. I feel like that's something that we can do to separate ourselves from like the bigger studios, for example, like just taking the time to show our clients, hey, I really care about getting to know who you guys are as a couple and individually. Like, I think it's just taking that extra step that sets us apart.
Absolutely. Just kind of as we wrap it up here, do you have like a signature pose that you would try to always do with your clients or that you're kind of known for?
I'm probably known for the one where I have them lay down and I shoot them from above. I really love to do that. I feel like it, with girls especially, I feel like it just brings out their eyes so much. So that's something I definitely do. And probably also having them just like touch noses and just get really like a close crop shot of their face. That's something I'm probably also known for.
So those are like your two little signature, you know, because we all have those as photographers, especially if you, you know, keyed in on your style and your niche. So I think that's awesome when it's like everyone knows that they're going to get at least a couple of poses like everyone always does. You know, that's really awesome.
Yeah, and I feel like a lot of times people come to us because they've seen shots that we've done of their friends or their family, and so they come to us kind of, you know, expecting at least to see some of that because they believe that that's our style.
Absolutely, absolutely. One last question as we wrap it up here. Have you ever had clients that, like, send you, you know, lots of poses that they want that you feel is not cohesive to your style of shooting, and what do you do about that?
Absolutely. As Pinterest has become more popular, see, when I got married, it was right before Pinterest came out. So there was no Pinterest for me to reference for poses. Like, there was, like, thenot.com, and that was about it.
Exactly.
But now that Pinterest has become popular with brides and with, you know, family sessions, anything like that, mm-hmm. I definitely do have a lot of people sending me pose ideas beforehand. And what I try to do is I just try to tell them, you know, depending on what kind of session it is or if it's a wedding, I tell them that they can pick, you know, five poses that they really, really just want us to try to get. But then with that being said, I don't guarantee, you know, absolutely that we will get those poses in the exact way. Sure. And the other thing I try to do just to set like healthy expectations is just telling people, you know, let your love story be your love story. You know, your pictures are not going to be the same as anyone else's, and that's what you want, because you don't want to try to be someone else. You want to be who you guys are as a couple. So that's something I try to do just to make sure that they know, you know, hey, just like let the moment happen as it's going to happen.
And that's a great way to just like tie it in with them, that you'll, you know, you'll encourage them to, that you'll do some of those poses, at least give them a shot. But like you said, just let their love story just resonate through their pictures and their images and their posing versus trying to fit, you know, this certain frame that they want to be from seeing on Pinterest or blogs or whatever. So that's awesome. I like that little piece of wisdom. Well, thanks so much for joining us today and giving us these tips and posing. And we'll be sure to circle back around to you.
Thanks so much for having me, Erin.